Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its mission, to explore strange new worlds. To discover new life and new civilizations. To boldly go where no man has gone before.
Captain's log, stardate 6223.8. We are en route to the glorious Pebble Scientific Academy, where we...
Enterprise, this is Captain Luke Rayner of the USS Alexander. We have returned from the future. In 8 days, the United Federation of Planets will be completely destroyed. A new...
My God. Captain's log supplemental. We have tracked the Alexander's course to Espoir Station, a scientific research facility in the Omega Maelstrom sector. We are about to set course for that system, hoping to discover the subject of its last ominous message.
Target analysis on.
Perhaps you should access my library computer, sir.
Orders are to proceed to Espoir Station, sir.
Espoir Station. Scientific research station situated near the Gravity's End proto-universe phenomenon. It is directed by Dr. James Monroe, originally of New Texas, Earth. Dr. James Monroe, Administrator of Espoir Station, graduated stardate 2251.9 from Princeton University with a doctorate in theoretical physics. His doctoral thesis was Temporal Anomalies in Type B Warp Fields.
Arming weapons. Disarming weapons.
Do not think that would have any effect, Captain.
Captain, a Delossi frigate is decloaking.
In addition to its cloaking capabilities, the ship is mounted with 3 forward-firing photon torpedo bays.
We are being hailed.
On screen.
This is Captain Bavander Zane of the Alassi Frigate Interdiction. You are no match for our new Storm-class frigates. We demand your immediate surrender.
Forget it. Give us 5 minutes to decide. No matter how good your ships are, they're still being captained by lice-ridden Alassi hypocrites. I would lose all self-respect surrendering to a person like you. Forget it. Give us 5 minutes to decide.
5 minutes for what? What kind of a fool do you take me for? Goodbye, Enterprise.
Arming weapons.
Raising shields.
Ah!
Captain, they are fleeing!
Captain's log. We have engaged in a battle against the Alasi. I cannot help but wonder if there is a connection between them and the message that we have received from the Alexander.
Captain, you don't seriously expect us to believe that the Alasi could threaten the Federation.
Those Cossacks couldn't threaten my grandmother.
It does seem inconsistent with what we know.
I'm still suspicious, Mr. Spock. Just call it human intuition.
Captain, I'm receiving a message from the station manager.
On screen.
Captain, I'm James Monroe, commander of Espoir Station. We witnessed your battle against the Alasi. They've bothered us a lot in the last few weeks. We're very grateful.
Do you mind if we come down and take a look at your station? Really? Then why haven't you filed reports with Starfleet? We've heard disturbing reports about your activities. We've come to take a look at your research. Do you mind if we come down and... Really? Then why have
we filed reports? We've received no communication from Starfleet in 2 weeks. We were wondering if someone wasn't jamming our transmissions. We're sending our coordinates. If you wish to discuss this in person, we'd be more than happy to receive you. Beam on down.
Captain's log.
Captain, the shields are up. Lower shields, Captain.
Greetings, Dr. Monroe. I'm Captain Kirk.
Yes, it's been made clear who you are, Captain Kirk. Espoir Station is glad to meet you. In fact, we have something interesting to show you.
That may be why we're here. What the...
The modified tractor overload beam can be quite lethal, Captain. I suggest you surrender immediately, or we will crack your ship like an egg.
Why are you doing this? You won't get away with this. How can a loyal Federation scientist do a thing like this? Why are you doing this? You won't get... How can a loyal Federation scientist do a thing like this?
Dr. Monroe's loyalty to the Federation is more tenuous than you believe, Kirk.
Bradell.
Jim, isn't he that maniac who wanted revenge on you and...
I am the one who headed the Verdane program to build our improved versions of your starships. And despite the setback caused by your interference, I survived.
I thought you were killed when your pathetic imitation of the Enterprise was destroyed.
Fortunately, a Clark Delassie frigate transported me before my bridge was destroyed. Fortunate for one of us, that is.
You intend to destroy the entire Federation? Is that the only thing you ever think of, Bradell? Revenge? Of course, Bradell, even surrounded by your goons. You're still too much of a coward to face me in person. You intend to destroy the entire Federation? Is that the only thing you ever think of, Bradell? Revenge?
Guards, put them in the brig and let them rot.
Welcome to Espoir, Captain Kirk. I've been asked to make certain your stay is uncomfortable. What did you do to Dr. Bradell anyway?
11 years ago, as a lieutenant on the Farragut, I exposed his scheme to overthrow the Vardane Council. They dismissed him from their science council in disgrace. He's vowed revenge ever since.
That explains it. Never get involved in politics or get on the good doctor's bad side.
It doesn't sound like you care that much for Bradell.
Well, he's never been interested in winning popularity contests. By the way, the name's Shem. Manao Shem.
The cold, hard surface of a prison floor. The cold, hard surface of a prison wall. 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 This is a standard security door with a force field. Manao Shem, a big security guard. Someone you'd rather not fight. Mr. Spock, wondering why logical solutions never seem to be very good at prison escapes. Dr. Leonard McCoy, who silently counts the hours remaining before the Federation is destroyed.
If there's ever been a mission that we mustn't fail, this is it.
It's somewhat humbling to know that over 100 billion people are depending on you.
Captain, I estimate the odds of finding and destroying Bradell's doomsday weapon at 186 to 1.
That's better odds than usual.
I am factoring in your record at performing nearly impossible feats, Captain. Otherwise, the odds would be 8,552 to 1.
What would I do without your encouragement, Spock?
I cannot speculate, Captain.
I'm getting a little too old to play hero, Jim.
But you do it so well, Bones.
What's on your mind, Captain?
Dr. McCoy, he's very sick. You wouldn't happen to be related to Vakata Sheen by any chance. Do you realize that you're working for a madman? When do we eat around here? Dr. McCoy, he's very sick. You wouldn't happen to be related to Vakata Sheen by any chance?
Yes. He was my father.
How's he doing?
He's dead. He tried to betray the Vardane Starship program to the Federation and was executed 9 years ago.
I'm sorry to hear that. I knew him when I was on Vardane. He was a good man.
Obviously, someone felt differently. Since then, Dr. Bradell took me under his wing. I proved more able as a security officer than as a scientist.
Then you should know that Bradell is insane. Why don't you try coming inside for a moment? Let's see how tough a security officer you are. And what do you think of your father's death? Then you should know that Bradell is insane. Why don't you... What do you think of your father's death?
How do you think I felt?
I called him my friend. He had the courage of his beliefs. It must have been difficult having people constantly saying that you are a traitor's son. How many times did Bradell say that to you? Help us avenge his death. 10 years ago, he helped me expose him to the Vardane Council. He died because he was Bradell's enemy, not because he was a traitor. If I can expose Bradell's plans, then your father's name will be cleared. I called him my friend. He had the courage of his beliefs.
I am glad that someone has good memories of him.
I cannot believe that Vakata Sheen's son would blindly follow Bradell. I have memories of a man of honor and compassion on a world that did not always admire those qualities. A man whose respect for life caused him to intercede when our landing party faced summary execution, when it would have been easier for him to let us be killed. You should have had one of the finest men I've ever known as a father, and instead, you were raised by a monster like Bradell. I pity you. I have memories of a man of honor.
I suppose he deserves to be repaid for his kindness. I'll help you, Captain.
This doesn't seem as strong as the other parts of the cell.